Welcome back. In the last class, we looked at flux being expressed as the product of a certain transfer coefficient times a certain driving force. This driving force was the difference in amounts rather than the gradient of that amount. Okay. For example, the mass flux was given as a product of the mass transfer coefficient and the concentration difference, and heat flux was given as the product of the heat transfer coefficient and the temperature difference, okay, 6.2.1-3 and so on. And then we said the limitation is that this the coefficients are specific for certain situations, so generalization becomes difficult. Let us take things further in this lecture. Now we are looking at the transport of oxygen from the gas phase to the liquid phase. We have the gas bubbles through which the transport occurs, or from which the transport occurs. So we are looking at the oxygen transport from the gas bubble to the liquid surrounding it. Okay. So in the liquid phase, we are looking at the liquid, the flux Na is given as the product of a certain mass transfer coefficient Kc times the concentration difference in the liquid phase, Ca1 minus Ca2. Okay. Equation 6.2.1-4, which can be written, this has been written in terms of concentrations. We can write them in terms of mole fractions also. It becomes easier many times to work in terms of mole fractions. So we write this as Kx, the transfer coefficient, and it is based on mole fraction, times the mole fraction at 1 minus the mole fraction at 2. Okay. Equation 6.2.1-5. In the gas phase, the flux of A, which is oxygen, is Kg times Pa1 minus Pa2 in the gas bubble, maybe 6.2.1-6, which can be written in terms of the mole fractions in the gas phase, Ky. This is the transfer coefficient in terms of the mole fraction, times the mole fraction at 1 minus the mole fraction at 2. Equation 6.2.1-7. Okay. So these are the flux definitions from our formulation, transfer coefficient times a certain difference in the driving force. Now, when we quantify mass transfer across phases, okay, from a gas phase to a liquid phase, from one liquid phase to another liquid phase, maybe an immiscible liquid phase, from liquid back to the gas or liquid to the solid, whatever it could be, the mass transfer coefficients are especially useful. Okay, and recall from thermodynamics that for mass transfer, it is the difference in chemical potentials that provides the actual driving force for mass transfer. This is true. Okay. However, chemical potentials are a lot more difficult to measure on a regular basis. Concentrations are far easier to measure. Therefore, we'd like our formulations to be in terms of whatever we can measure easily, right, to be directly used. And therefore, we'd try to overcome this need for chemical potential by some sort of a roundabout method which uses concentrations. Okay, and however, retain the use of the concentration and thereby the ease of application. In a single phase, the approximation of concentration difference or chemical potential difference, that works well. Okay, it doesn't matter whether you use the difference in chemical potential or the difference in concentration. As long as you couple it with an appropriate transfer coefficient, this will work. The flux will perfectly work. But across phases or interphase, from one phase to another interphase, that approximation of course becomes difficult. And more importantly, chemical potentials are not easy to measure, that I just mentioned. And use of a suitable concentration for chemical potential becomes easier with the use of a mass transfer coefficient. There are many methods, including experiments, correlations, and theories to find the transfer coefficients. Now, we are going to consider the transfer of a species A, could be oxygen, across two phases 1 and 2, represented as 1/2, from 1 to 2. Okay. And there are several possibilities here. G slash L represents the transfer of A between a solid, between a gas phase and a liquid phase. This is G, therefore this has to be a gas phase and a liquid phase. S slash L represents the transfer between a solid phase and a liquid phase. L slash L represents the transfer of A between two liquid phases that are immiscible and so on. If they are miscible, it's just one liquid phase, right? So, and so on. Okay, so we are going to look at gas liquid because we are looking at the transfer of oxygen from the gas bubble to the liquid broth, the gas liquid transport. The basal representations remain the same whatever be the two phases under consideration. Okay, so it doesn't really matter for the applicability of our formulation what the two phases are. Okay, it could be GL, it could be SL, LL, and so on. Okay, now let us consider this to be the interface between phase 1 and phase 2. Phase 1 happens to be a gas, phase 2 happens to be a liquid in this case. This is the gas bubble, this is the liquid broth. The oxygen concentration at the middle of the gas bubble is taken as YAG and it is expected to be higher if the bubble is not well mixed. If the bubble is well mixed, probably this is going to be a flat line here. And let us assume a reasonably general case where the bubble is not well mixed and therefore the concentration away from the interface, of course this is going to be a spherical interface, is going to be greater than the interfacial mole fraction of A. Similarly, in the liquid phase, this is the interfacial mole fraction of A and this is the bulk mole fraction of A. Recall equilibrium, YAI and XAI are related in a certain way. The easiest or the approximated relationship for a short range and so on and so forth is a linear relationship. YAI equals M times XAI can be used here. Okay, the overall thing is a lot more complex. You recall the Y versus X graph, the equilibrium curve, it goes something like this. Okay, so if you do a piecewise consideration of that curve, then that variation could be considered as a linear variation that we'll look at in detail in a little bit. The flux of A in the gas phase is a gas side coefficient Ky times YAG minus YAI, okay? Mass transfer coefficient times the concentration difference. In this case, mole fraction difference, the mass transfer coefficient is in terms of the mole fractions. Ky is the gas phase mass transfer coefficient. Let's call this equation 6.2.1-8. The flux of A in the liquid phase here in this phase is Kx, the mass transfer coefficient, the individual mass transfer coefficient as it is called on this side, times the concentration difference XAI minus XAL. We'll call this 6.2.1-9. Kx is the liquid phase mass transfer coefficient. Lewis and Whitman, way back in 1924, proposed that the resistances to mass transfer reside only in the phases and across the interface or at the interface, there is no resistance to mass transfer. Okay, that's what they said. What does this mean? The change in concentrations will happen more slowly here. It will happen instantaneously here. Because of that, at the interface, this gas phase and the liquid phase can be considered to be in equilibrium. That's what they said. Okay, it's a very powerful thing to say. This is what they proposed. Consequently, the concentrations YAI and XAI at the interface are equilibrium concentrations that I just mentioned. And this has actually been verified by very careful experiments. Okay, at the interface, it is indeed at equilibrium. The gas phase concentration and the liquid phase concentration are at their equilibrium values. However, the interface concentrations are not easy to measure. It calls for very fine instrumentation, very careful measurements to measure at the interface. Bulk, far easier to measure. So we need our formulation in terms of the bulk concentrations. So we use bulk concentrations and an overall mass transfer coefficient. An overall mass transfer coefficient that goes from here to here. Note that these two are different. These are apples, these are oranges. But let us see how to formulate them. X and Y are concentrations in different phases. They are different quantities and the denominator volumes are also different. Okay, gas phase volume is different from liquid phase volume. So the concentrations, you know, which are normalized with respect to volume, there are a lot of difficulties. And hence, algebraic operations cannot be done with them. You cannot put them together. The way around that difficulty is to use the concentration in one phase that is supposed to be in equilibrium with the bulk concentration in the other phase. Okay. So, you use the concentration in one phase that is supposed to be in equilibrium with the other concentration, with the bulk concentration in the other phase, and that would provide the driving force. Okay. Let me go further and it will become clearer. For example, for our gas liquid transport, Na equals recall Na was, if you looked at let me tell you this here itself. Na we said was a ky times yag minus yai. Okay, that is the individual mass transfer coefficient here, and on this side it was some kx times xai minus xal. This is what we saw. Now we are trying to relate this and this. In other words, we are trying to relate the flux in terms of the bulk concentration here and the bulk concentration here. How do we do that? We write this as some overall capital ky times yag minus a certain ya star. The ya star is not an actual concentration, it's a conceptual concentration. Ya star is the concentration that is in equilibrium with xal. Okay, so it essentially converts this into an equivalent concentration here, and thereby we could do algebraic operations. It converts an apple to an orange, and thereby we can subtract apples, add apples, whatever it is. Okay, that is what happens here, and this is equation 6.2.1-10. Ya star is a concentration in the gas phase that will be in equilibrium, that is at equilibrium when the liquid phase concentration is xal. The corresponding gas phase concentration is Ya star. Okay. So that is what I mentioned here. I think and capital Ky is the overall mass transfer coefficient from the gas phase to the liquid phase. Let me just say this thing and let you soak this in for a while. We said we will do this lecture in very many different, we will do this topic in very many different lectures, short lectures, so that it will help you understand further. So let me mention this and take a break. This flux can also be represented as the other thing. You could write the overall mass transfer coefficient in terms of the liquid phase also. So that is written as a capital Kx times a certain xal, xa star minus xal. Xal is the bulk concentration here. Xa star is a conceptual concentration. It's not something that can be measured. However, what this represents is the liquid phase concentration in equilibrium with yag. So we have represented yag through an equivalent concentration in the liquid phase, and thereby we could do these manipulations. We could do these algebraic manipulations. So Na equals Kx times Xa star minus Xal, 6.2.1-11. And let me take a break here for you to internalize this. And then when we come back, I'll re-emphasize this further. See you in the next class. Bye.